A Friday, did we not? Yes, it is. For you working stiffs out there, TGIF. Thank God it's Friday. For me personally, it's thank God I'm fried. Anyway, today's show, on a semi-serious note, because it should be taken serious, but I think that's part of a problem. We're not taking a lot of this stuff that's happening every day in our lives that is just appalling. Stuff that's happening nowadays, gang, is just, I'll tell you what, if this stuff was happening back in 1965 or even 75, it just, yeah, I'm telling you, I just, anyway, yeah, I don't know, you know, it's kind of hard to do a show like this when, I don't know where we get the point and who, you know, far be it, from, you know, this is just a hobby of mine. I'm far from a professional broadcaster of any level, you know. It's just, but I am a person of concern, and I'm a person that cares, and I'm hoping that maybe we can turn this country around and get some sanity back with that just being enough, but evidently it's not. I don't know. You know, I worry about my grandkids. Hell, I worry about my own sons in a way. Of which I got to get this out to my son Josh. If you happen to be listening, and if you are really stupid. I mean, no. it's my son's birthday. My son's 42nd birthday. Our oldest son, Josh. Have a great day, buddy. And we'll see you later on today. And we're gonna celebrate your 42nd birthday together. Okay. So, are you buying any old duels for the old man? Okay, all right. Anyways, happy birthday, son. We love you. Have a good day at your new job. Okay, son, see you later. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. You belong in a zoo. No, anyway. Anyways, happy birthday, Josh. Okay, haven't said that. It is. It's, and this title of this show is, if I can remember, it's something like, can we get our, we're missing a country and sanity, and some sanity. Yes, we are. But I tell you, I don't know where you even begin. It's just, you know, and it's hard to do any show. Who, see, here's the thing. It's like a fine line. It's like a catch-22. People don't want to hear this kind of stuff, right? Generally speaking. So who the hell's going to listen to me spiel about this stuff? But at the same time, on the flip side, this stuff is, you know, if we totally ignore it like we have been doing, I mean, what's the outcome for all of us? I mean, it's not good. So somewhere down the line, we have to shake ourselves up or bang ourselves in the head and wake up from this toxic, it's like a Matrix. You guys know Matrix movies. It's kind of like a Matrix. We're all pretending that all this stuff, either it's bullshit, it's made up, it's just for news, it's just for, you know, but it's not. This stuff is real. Missing children, the sex scandals, people in politics, a bunch of crooks, and it just goes on and on and on. It's, I don't know. It's crazy. Okay, we'll title that under our cuckoo bird section. It's cuckoo time. It's cuckoo time. That's it. File all this under cuckoo time, because the whole damn place is going right flying out the window with the cuckoo birds. Okay, now on a lighter note here, and this is what my show is all about. It's my little hobby. I don't try to bullshit anybody. I'm far from, as you can tell by now, I'm far from a professional at this, but I do have a passion to do this, and I do want to continue to do it, and stuff like that. I just hope I can get some kind of a more a response level or some kind of a listening group of people with some sanity, and people are just, I have the answers? Hell no, I don't have the answers. Do I have the concerns? Yeah. Do I have the passion? Yeah. And do I think this will do any good? Maybe. Maybe. I don't know. But anyways, I do know some good news here. In the local area. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, coming to you live from the Twin Cities area, where we're just all getting all Google-eyed and gaga-eyed, spending billions of dollars on young men in this country that's going to put a round sphere ball in through a hoop. And they're putting up Ferris wheels, and they got all this stuff. You know, God, will you give me a break? God almighty. That's part of the sanity. It is. It's part of the sanity. You know, and they're throwing axes on the roof up there at CCO, studio down there. They're throwing axes. I have no idea what axes have to do with basketball. I don't know. I thought lumberjack days was saved for like Stillwater and up north or something, but no, they got lumberjacks mixed in with basketball. Okay, there you go. Let's yep, it's cuckoo. Alrighty, I once dated the Noxzema girl. Yes, I did. And she told me, take it all off and leave it off. Yeah, she did. Oh, I forgot my little... Okay. I gotta interject my manufactured laughter button, because who the hell's gonna laugh at this shit anyway? But, you know, I can make it, there again, it's just imagination, have a little fun, and, yeah, and it was one, Mars people, they wrote about Captain Boomer's show here. They said, Captain Boomer's show is where imagination, creativity, nostalgia, and medication all come together. Thank you. Yeah. A good level of humanity bring us back to some sanity? I certainly hope so. And I believe that all the politicians, before they're even elected for any government type official job, they all should have lie detector tests. What do you think of that? Yeah. I like it. Anyways, today's musical guest is going to be none other than Mr. Paul Simon. Paul Simon's up on deck, and what else are we going to do here? And he's going to be playing some stuff. Okay. Today is, you know, we got all these national days out there. Oh, National Pet Your Dog Day, National Change Your Kitty Litter Box Day, National Start an Ant Farm Day, National Clip Your Toenails Day. You know, here. Yeah, stick that up here. Anyway, how about something like this? And God damn it, it makes sense to me. And I would love to see something like this. How about if today, gang, is National Buy a Veteran Coffee Day? What do you think of that? Huh?
Hey, how you doing? I tell you,
hey,
we want the group here. We want two pitchers of beer. We want one every 7 minutes until somebody passes out.
No beer.
And then after that, give us one every 5 minutes. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Right, I'm going to have you check in with me with the AA if you keep that drinking up. Anyway, yes, it's National Buy a Veteran Coffee Day. Yeah. And if you want to take it a little further, buy him breakfast, you know? I mean, you know, we all can piss our money away on shit that don't matter to anybody. It doesn't change our lives or make us feel any better. We think it does. We inundate ourselves with crap that we really don't need. How about buying a bed a cup of coffee, huh? I'm telling you what. It's a win-win situation. You'll feel damn good that you did it. And you know what? That veteran will feel damn good that you did it. Yep, and he'll feel better about himself. And that's what it's all about, ain't it? Trying to make each other feel better about ourselves and our why we're here and what we're doing here, all that kind of stuff. But, okay, we're going to go ahead and we're going to be playing a little bit of my buddy. He's not my buddy, but I mean, I've always liked Paul Simon's music. Simon and Garfunkel, yeah, all right. But I think Paul really, well, Paul was the most talented. Garfunkel, he just had the goofy hair and a high soprano voice because whatever. But the real talent is obviously with Mr. Paul Simon. And here he is. Paul Simon's up on deck now. And Paul Simon's going to be playing a little. I hope you enjoy this. It's going to be me and the wife we took a trip down there. Yes, we did. To the old Graceland. Well, this is Graceland, but you get the idea. You'll get the idea. Okay, I'm working on it. I gotta get me Graceland, baby. Here we go. Memphis, Tennessee.
Yeah.